Hello, what is up? How is everyone today? I'm really excited to be on live right now because I feel like I've been MIA from my Facebook live game for a little while. Thanks for watching, replay viewers. Welcome, live viewers, once you start popping on. My name is Heidi Papoff, and I am coming to you live. That's what I'm trying to say. From Eugene, Oregon. Thanks for jumping on. Hi, Tammy. So, who am I? I'm Heidi Papoff. I am a wife, a mom, I'm a real estate agent. I'm also partnered with an online wellness company, which I absolutely love all of my, you know, jack of all trades persona. And one of my big missions in life is to help people live a healthier, happier life, whether that is through helping you buy or sell real estate or helping you with your health and wellness, or just coming on here and giving you everyday tips for living a healthier, happier life. So I was thinking, like, what do people need to hear? What's something people need for, you know, just everyday better wellness in their lives? And it really can be as simple as just, how do you have a better day every day? What can you do on a daily basis to just have a better day? And, you know, this is something that I know I need to be reminded about. And these can be so simple. And most of these are so simple. But sometimes we just get up in the morning and we just go on autopilot and we start going about our day. And we don't really live with intention in a way to make ourselves have a better day. So write these down, start using this tomorrow morning. You can even start doing some of these today. Some of them are things that you do first thing in the morning, so you'll want to start those tomorrow morning, but a lot of these can just be implemented throughout the day. So the first thing is, and I might add in a couple of things because I feel like these can be a little bit expanded upon, but the first thing is to get up and start your day with exercise. So I know that might sound like a big undertaking. You know, you don't have to get up like an hour or 2 hours earlier than usual and head off to the gym and do something fancy. You can get up, and if you are into yoga, you can do some sun salutations, stretch, do something like that. You can get up and do some sit-ups, some push-ups, something simple, some jumping jacks. Just get the blood flowing, get your body moving, be in gratitude for the fact that you can do those things, as, you know, advanced or not advanced or as simple as it is. Like, if you can get up and do some jumping jacks, if you can get up and do some sit-ups or some planks like David Bujanos, you have a reason to be in gratitude for the fact that your body is working. Hi, David. Thanks for joining. So, I mean, that in itself, just getting up and being grateful, is going to start your day off on the right foot. And that would be something that I would say even before you get up and exercise, wake up and start immediately thinking about, what are you grateful for today? What are you looking forward to today? What can you thank God or the universe for today? And that's going to automatically put you in a better mood, put a smile on your face, and then get up and do some exercise in whatever form works for you, whatever amount of time works for you. I get up and I work out in my living room in front of the TV with YouTube, and it's free. It's, you know, usually 20 to 30 to maybe 40 minutes long, but I always feel better. I feel, you know, grateful to myself that I got up and I did it. I feel grateful that my body works and functions for me and all of that. And then, you know, I will feel a little bit better about myself because my muscles are starting to develop, or, you know, my jeans start fitting better or whatever. So that's number one, get up and exercise in the morning. Number two, and again, this is so simple, but something that a lot of us forget to do on a daily basis, and that is eat well. You know, pick healthy things, nourish your body in a way that shows yourself that you value yourself. You know, sometimes life happens, we're on a road trip, we're in a hurry or whatever, you might have to eat fast food. Just don't make that a daily habit. You're not going to feel good. It sets the tone for your day. You know, if you go in on your way to work and you stop at McDonald's and you eat something heavy and then you get there and you're automatically like sluggish and not feeling good, that just really sets the tone for your day and it tends to spiral in a downward motion to, you know, more unhealthy choices, not really setting you on a trajectory to feel good that day. So eat well, and that just means being prepared. You know, you have to be kind of intentional the day before about what you're going to eat the next day. If you have to get up in the morning and leave the house, like make sure that you have that ready to take with you or just have a plan. And so all of these, as simple as they may be, could require a little bit of lifestyle changes or, you know, figuring out how to be better with your time, more intentional, things like that. But it is worth it. And anything that you can do, McGriddles, anything that you can do to change your lifestyle for the better is investing in yourself and investing in your future and creating a healthier, happier life. So number three, again, so simple, but wear something that makes you feel happy and confident. You know, when I was looking up these tips online, it said wear a killer outfit. Now, you know, it could be a little bit more simple than that. Just put on clothes that make you feel good. If you, you know, have clothes in your closet that you look at them and they just make you feel like, ugh, I don't want to wear that. I don't like that. Get rid of it, actually. I mean, that's, you know, the whole Marie Kondo, like, if it doesn't bring you joy, give it away. And I mean, it's so true for your clothes too. If you haven't touched it or if you look in your closet every day and you see that shirt and no part of you wants to grab it and put it on, why keep it? You know, get rid of that shirt and replace it with something. Even if, you know, you shop at the used clothing store, find something that makes you feel happy and makes you feel good when you put it on and confident, and you're going to just have a better day. All of this is just ways to have a better day. Number four, avoid situations that stress you out. Okay, so obviously there are things in our lives that we can't avoid all of the time. You know, a lot of people, I know you like to wear jeans when you plank, David Bujanos, and if that makes you happy, then that is what you get to do. So we all have things in our lives that we can't always avoid. Like if you have a job that you hate, first of all, I would say start taking action toward changing that, but maybe you can't change that tomorrow, okay? So I'm not necessarily talking about things like that, but I am talking about that on a grander scale. Hi, Alicia, thanks for joining me. If there are things in your life that really cause you ongoing stress, chronic stress, definitely work on changing that, but that might not be something you can do right away. But, you know, if you know there are situations that stress you out, like certain people that you don't enjoy being around that you can avoid, do that. One of the examples that was given in this article is if you know, it's all about just like knowing yourself and knowing what puts you in a good mood or a bad mood. But if you know that slow walkers infuriate you, and you're walking on the sidewalk and you're behind a slow walker and you can cross the street and get away from them, do that. Like, there's just little ways all the time that you can find to take care of yourself. Like you know who, David Bujanos. So avoid situations that stress you out when you can, as often as you can. And that's just a matter of being aware of how you feel around certain situations, how you feel around certain people, and listening to yourself and honoring that in yourself. Because my belief is that peace of mind is the greatest thing that we can strive for on a daily basis. Now, what brings each of us peace of mind is going to be very individual, but finding out what that is and then trying to design a life that brings that to you more and more is what I believe for myself is what I strive for. I want to create as much peace of mind in my life as possible, and it's an ongoing process to find what that is and how to get there, but that's my goal. And then number five, do something nice for yourself. So this can be big or small. This can be, you know, going for a massage, That would be something for me right now that's a little bit bigger. For some people, big might be, you know, going on vacation. But just, you know, little daily things is what we're talking about more. So if that is like making time in the day to sit down and watch your favorite television show, it can be so simple. If it's taking a bath at the end of the day, it can be setting aside time to meditate. You know, rewarding yourself in some way that shows you that you love you, you're worthy of the enjoyment that it gets, and you're doing something nice for yourself. Because self-care and self-love is really going to set the tone for your whole life and allow you to probably, you know, put enough time and value in yourself to even do any of these five steps that I just talked about. Because if you're not valuing you, then you're not going to invest the time or the effort to do these things, to invest in yourself, to make yourself have a better day. These things are very simple, but I bet any person watching this can make an excuse for any single one of these as to why not to do it. And what you get to do if you want to start having better days is actually come up with reasons why you can do these things and why it is important to do these things for yourself. So I hope that this was helpful for somebody watching. I hope it brought you value, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your Wednesday, and thank you for tuning in with me. Bye-bye.